Hello scholars, you know, today I am going to take you for a nature walk. Interesting, na? And meanwhile, I am going to tell you one interesting thing. You know what? That is onomatopoeic word. Have you heard about this? So today I am going to tell you onomatopoeic word. It sounds very interesting for me and I hope for you all also. So let's start. See scholars, it's a chapter 7 from our workbook. In previous video, we already finished chapter 7 from our students book, right? So today, I'm going to start this poem from our workbook. The name of the poem or the title of the poem is Nature is What We See. Okay, what is the nature that we can see? Okay, and the poet of this is Emily Dickinson. Okay, so let's start. Nature is what we see. The hill, the afternoon, squirrel, eclipse, the bumblebee. Means what is nature? Nature is the very simple thing, the thing which we can see. What we can see in nature? We can see the hill, the afternoon. Afternoon was also very beautiful, right? If you will try to observe afternoon, you can see beauty of that. You can feel the beauty of afternoon. Okay. And squirrel. Have you seen a squirrel? Yes. It's very, cute, very cute animal. Right? Eclipse. Do you know about eclipse? Eclipse means when any planet blocks the light from other planet, then it can be called as eclipse. Okay, the bumblebee. Bumblebee means the bee or any insect which makes buzz sound. Okay, buzz sound, that can be called the bumblebee. We are talking about here bee, that's why here it's given bumblebee, the bee which makes buzz sound. Okay, nature is heaven. Nature is what we hear. The bobolink, the sea, thunder, the cricket. Okay, so what else is nature? Nature is heaven. If you means many people are going for a tour, going Kashmir for a tour, and what they are trying to see there, they are trying to see beauty of the nature, and they we all are saying and we know that Kashmir is next to heaven, right? In beauty. Nature is what we hear. We can see our nature. We can hear our nature. We can hear our nature how? We can hear the bobolink. Bobolink is a kind of bird, and that bird is singing song. Okay, so that is very famous bird, and that bird is not from India, that is from America, but it's present in our nature and very famous for it's for her song. Okay, so we can hear that in our nature. The sound of the sea, the sound of the thunder, the sound of the cricket. Cricket means it's a kind of insect which makes a lot of noise during before rainy season, and before rainy season we can hear cricket sound. Okay, cricket is here not bat ball. Okay, don't be confused. It's an insect, and we are talking about insect. So nature which we can see, nature which we can hear. Nay, nature is harmony. Nature is what we know, yet have no art to say. So important our wisdom is to her simplicity. Okay, nature is harmony. Nature is what we know, yet have no art to say. Means nature is harmony means it's a relation, peaceful relation between us, humans, animals, and whatever present in our nature. Nature is so simple. In fact, we can say that in front of nature, our wisdom is powerless. Our wisdom is helpless in front of her simplicity. Here, her is for nature. We are comparing nature as a female gender. Okay, okay, very beautiful poem it seems. And now we will move to worksheet 2. Okay, before that, answer these questions. First question is, what can the speaker see and hear in nature? Very simple, right? It's given in first paragraph only. What can the speaker see and hear in nature? The speaker can see the hill, the afternoon, the squirrel, eclipse, and bumblebee in nature. And the speaker can hear the bobolink, the sea, the thunder, and the cricket. See, scholars, here I wrote answer from my side, right? Which I understood from the poem. And what you have to do, you can write your own answer also, but it should be related to the poem. Okay? Yes. Now we will move to next worksheet. Yes. What is given here? Find out the meaning of the highlighted words using context clues. Okay, first one is, the palace was situated on a high solitary hill. There were no other hills for miles on the road. So which word is highlighted here? Solitary. Okay, and what is the meaning of solitary? We have to write meaning. I am going to do one or two, rest you have to do by yourself, because it's very simple work to find out meanings from the dictionary, right? And you have to find out only highlighted words. So I'm going to give only one meaning. This solitary means lonely. The palace was situated on a high lonely hill. There were no other hills for miles on the road. Okay, next. Yes, now onomatopoeic words. Okay, about which I told in starting, that we are going to understand today onomatopoeic words. What are onomatopoeic words? Onomatopoeia is the process of creating a word that phonetically imitates, resembles, or suggests the sounds that it describes. Means such kind of words are not having any their own meanings. Okay, these are the words which are created or which suggest the sound itself. Means when we are describing sound, and this, like if water falls on water, or if liquid falls on other liquid, then it creates one sound, right? So that sound we are going to study today, that the sounds which are created by itself and they are not having any particular meaning, they are phonetically just suggest that sound. Okay, such a word itself is called an onomatopoeia. For example, oink, meow. Have you heard this sound? Obviously. But what is the meaning of this sound, meow? No meaning, right? This is only a sound which was created by cat or kitten, right? Next, roar. Roar of lion. Have you heard the meaning of roar? No, there is no any meaning of roar. It's just a sound which was created by, which is created by lions. This is birds chirping, right? Chirping sound. What is the meaning of chirping? Nothing. It's a onomatopoeic word. It's created by birds. This sound is created by birds, and this sound is not carrying any meaning. So on the basis of this, we are going to solve our next worksheet. In this worksheet, what do these onomatopoeic words describe? First one is chomp. Chomp means this sound made while eating fast. When we are eating fast, one kind of sound is coming, and that sound is chomp. Okay, and the last one, pitter patter. Pitter patter, you all know about this sound. Sounds of raindrops. Okay, when you will try to observe during rainy season, you can get this sound, pitter patter, like this, when raindrops are falling. Okay, So next, we will move to next exercise now. See scholars, what we have to do here? Here in this worksheet, it's given, use the present perfect tense to complete these sentences. Okay, so present perfect tense, I will explain you in deep when we will do it in grammar textbook. Now, you have to remember only that in a sentence, there is subject, verb and object, right? So present perfect tense means, what is the rule for this? That subject plus has or have, according to singular and plural subject, has, have, and past participle form of the verb. Past participle form of the verb means third form of the verb. Okay, this is the rule for present perfect tense. So you have to remember only this. So on the basis of this, first one is I dash my homework. So I have completed my homework. So what I did here, I just added have and past participle form of the verb which is given here. Okay, in the same way we will do fourth one. Mithali's mood dash good since last evening. Mithali's mood has not been good since last evening. Why I added here has and here have? Because I is exception. Okay, I is exception. With I we can add have only, and in singular form means Mithali's, we are talking about one person. Okay, so with singular we can add only singular auxiliary means has. Okay, with plural we can add have. Okay, so on the basis of this rule you have to solve rest of the questions. Okay, rewrite these sentences using the past perfect tense. Okay, in previous one we did present perfect and here we have to do past perfect tense. Make changes were needed. Make changes were needed. Okay, my sister performs brilliantly in the show. What we have to do? We have to change in past perfect tense. My sister performs brilliantly in the show. What will come answer? My sister had performed brilliantly in the show. So what changes I did? I added here had and I changed the verb into past participle. Ed I added. My sister had performed brilliantly in the show. Okay, so in the same way, okay, one more we will do. She fell ill because she was eating out last weekend. She had fallen ill. What I did here, I added had and fell will change into fallen. Past participle form of fell. She had fallen ill because she had eaten out. Eating is there, right? In original sentence, it's given eating and I changed it into eaten. She had fallen ill because she had eaten out last weekend. Okay, so in the same way you have to solve rest of the sentence till B. Okay, and in next video we will continue this chapter from our workbook only and we'll try to complete this. Okay, we'll try to finish this. Okay, so till that time, take care. Bye bye.